Hello children, respiration is the process that all living things go through to create the energy they need to live. Today, we will understand the journey of air inside the human body. Children, now is the time to learn more about the process of respiration. Come, let's watch this video.
At the end of this module, you will be able to define respiration, differentiate between respiration and breathing, prove that carbon dioxide is given out during respiration, tell about some of the early studies done in the field of respiration and combustion, differentiate between respiration and combustion. The process by which a living being utilizes the food to get energy is called respiration. Respiration is actually an oxidation reaction in which carbohydrate is oxidized to produce energy. This happens in the cells, so it is also called cellular respiration. The term respiration is derived from Latin word respire, meaning to breathe.
Do you know that respiration and breathing are not the same? Let us learn about their differences.
Breathing. Respiration. Movement of air into and out of the lungs. Breakdown of food to release energy. Muscles are involved. Muscles are not involved. Energy is not released. Energy is released. Takes place in and out of the lungs. Takes place in all body cells.
Children, now we will conduct a simple experiment to show that carbon dioxide is released during breathing.
If you exhale in a test tube that contains lime water, you will notice that it would turn milky, proving that carbon dioxide is given out during respiration. You will get the same results if you burn glucose in a test tube, the gas produced by burning of sugar lime water. This also shows that carbon dioxide is given out when burned.
Kids, various gases and the process of respiration was not discovered in a day. Many scientists worked hard to bring all this information to us. Let us learn about some famous scientists who studied the process of respiration.
Joseph Priestley carried out an experiment that showed that plants produce oxygen. He put a mint plant in a closed container with a burning candle. The candle flame used up the oxygen and went out. After 27 days, Priestley was able to relight the candle. This showed that plants produce a gas that allows fuels to burn. This gas later came to be known as the oxygen. The credit for discovering the true nature of respiration goes to Antoni Lavoisier. He showed that respiration was a process of combustion with the utilization of oxygen and the production of carbon dioxide. The early scientists believed that all materials contained a mysterious substance called phlogiston. They thought that when burnt, these materials release some of its phlogiston. Lavoisier disproved the existence of phlogiston when he heated mercury so that it became mercury calx. When Lavoisier heated the calx even further, it converted back into mercury and oxygen gas, which proved that there was no such thing as phlogiston. Lavoisier conducted many more experiments to understand the process of combustion properly. He heated different materials in air and carefully weighing them before and after heating. Every time, he found out that the materials do not lose any of their ingredients. In fact, they often appear to absorb something from the atmosphere. This is when Lavoisier heard that Priestley has discovered a gas that encouraged the process of burning. Lavoisier proved with his experiments that the unknown quantity absorbed from the atmosphere during burning was in fact the newly identified gas, which he called oxygen. He then defined burning as the uniting of a substance with oxygen. a definition which is still used today. Before we move forward, let us also understand the difference between combustion and respiration. During combustion or burning, the oxygen of the air combines with the compound and releases energy in one step. In cells, during respiration, energy is released in the series of steps and the oxidation is slower. The differences between respiration and combustion are respiration, combustion, respiration. It takes place in living cells only. Combustion. It does not take place in the living cell. Respiration. It is carried out with the help of various enzymes. Combustion. Enzymes are not involved in this process. Respiration. The oxidation of food and the release of energy occur in a stepwise manner. Combustion. There is a sudden release of energy. Respiration. It occurs at the body temperature of the organism. Combustion. Sudden release of energy generates high temperature. Respiration. 60% of energy escapes as body heat and 40% of energy is stored in the body in form of ATP molecules. Combustion. Energy released in combustion is dissipated as heat and to some extent as light. By the end of this module, you have learnt about respiration. Difference between respiration and breathing. The carbon dioxide is given out during respiration. Some of the early studies done in the field of respiration and combustion. Difference between respiration and combustion.